Did you know your brain is plastic? Not like this or this, but plastic in the sense that it can change and reshape itself. The word plastic originates from the Greek word plasticus, which means to grow or to form. Neuroscientists have coined the term neuroplasticity to refer to the fact that the brain can change and rewire its connections. The brain is made out of billions of cells called neurons, and these neurons communicate with one another via connections called synapses. Each neuron in your brain can communicate with thousands of other cells. The brain has long been conceptualized as a hard-wired, unchanging machine. Now, this is a problem because your brain is responsible for qualities such as intelligence, talent, and motor abilities. And so if the brain is unchanging, then these qualities are also unchanging, and all of your characteristics are predetermined by birth. However, now we know that the brain adapts and rewires itself to your lived experiences. Dr. Norman Doidge, author of the New York Times bestseller, The Brain That Changes Itself, has a very interesting term for this view of the unchanging brain, and that is neurological nihilism. This term gets right to the point. Think about it. How many times did you hear someone say, "I'm just bad at math," or "I can't play basketball for the life of me," or "I'm just a lazy procrastinator," or whatever negative quality people might attribute to themselves? People say these things with despair, implying that there's nothing they can do to change, that these things are out of their control, that they're just built that way. And while this view of neurological nihilism has been eradicated from the field of neuroscience, it is still lurking in the public to a high degree. And that is why I want to start Neuro Inspiration, where I will be addressing practical neuroscientific and psychological concepts that apply to everyday life. By no means do I consider myself an expert in these fields, although I will be receiving an undergraduate degree in the field of neuroscience very soon. And again, I don't mention this to imply that I'm even close of becoming an expert in neuroscience or psychology, but I say this because I found great inspiration in learning more about how the brain and the psyche work as an undergraduate student. And I hope that by sharing these concepts with you, you too can derive inspiration from learning more about how your brain and your psyche work. And hopefully realize that by learning more about how the human brain works, truly the sky is the limit.